family. Well, welcome, welcome, welcome to our Sunday School Lesson Channel. I am super excited about what God is going to share with us on today. Let me welcome all of my new people to the channel. If this is your first time coming on this channel, I want to welcome you. This is a Bible-based channel where we, number one, take the Word of God, where we study the Word of God, where we apply the Word of God to our lives, and where we share the Word of God with others. So I pray that you get something on today that will enable you to do just that. For those of you that have been every week coming to this channel, I appreciate you. I thank God for you, and I pray that you are growing each and every week from our studies in His Word. So let us go ahead on before I give the topic or anything and open up in a word of prayer. Father God, in the name of Jesus, I just thank you right now for what it is that you are doing in my life, in the life of your people, Father God. And I just pray right now that what you gave me, Lord God, I'm able to give back, oh God. And then, Lord God, that we all can use it to apply it to our day-to-day walk and also to share it with others. I thank you again, Lord God, for using little old me, oh God. You get the glory out of this. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, family, that song that you heard when we came on, it was Get Ready by Darwin Hobbs. Get Ready by Darwin Hobbs. So guess what? Get ready, family, because we're about to get in to this lesson on today. I titled this one, I kind of did two different titles. One is Cycle of Faith. But then the other one I said was faith cycle. So, you know, it's the same way, different spin on words, cycle of faith or faith cycle. Our reference scripture is going to be Romans 10 and 17. Romans 10 and 17. And I'm reading from the NIV version, and it says, consequently, faith comes from hearing the message, and the message is heard through the word about Christ. So after reading this scripture on Sunday morning of last week, so every morning I do my little devotional soap. Remember, guys, y'all remember I was soap devotional. So I do my little soap study every morning. And on Sunday of last week, the one that I did was this particular scripture, Romans 10 and 17. And after reading that scripture, God began to give me words to share with y'all. God began to just fill my spirit with talking about faith. And then he just dropped some nuggets that I wanted to share with you guys about how this faith cycle usually works. You know, for each person, it's different. But basically, this is what it comes down to. So the first thing that is number one, hearing the word. So Romans 10 and 17, it said that. It talks about hearing the word of God. And then the word about Christ. So that's how a person is initially introduced to the saving knowledge of Jesus Christ, is through the word. And so I believe the first step to becoming a believer is that we first must hear the word of God. We gotta hear the word of God. And how is a person gonna hear the word of God? So through each and every one of us, hopefully we get an opportunity. I have three scriptures that I wanna share with you in this particular area. The first one is John 8 and 47. And it says, whoever belongs to God hears what God says. The reason you do not hear is that you do not belong to God. The next one is Luke 11 and 28. He replied, blessed rather are those who hear the word of God and obey it. And the last one is Isaiah 55 and 3. And it says, give ear and come to me. Listen that you may live. I will make an everlasting covenant with you, my faithful love promised to David. So the first step, like I said, I believe is hearing the word of God. And we know that I pray that that's what we get off of these lessons that we have on Sundays, is that we get an opportunity to gain some wisdom, gain some knowledge of what God's word is saying, so that we can go out and share it with someone else to help them to be able to do the same things that we are doing. So that is the first part that I believe in this faith cycle, in this cycle of faith. And then after that, after we hear the word, after we get the word from wherever we get it from, whether it's a church, a person on the street, anywhere, once we hear that word and it begins to move in our hearts, stir us on. The next step is, there's four, I believe, there's four responses that I want to share with you having to do with after you hear the word of God. And the first one is to receive it and accept God's word, to receive it and accept it, believing that what God's word says is true. So that is the first response, that we have to accept it and believe it. You know, so when we come, and for some of you guys, you already are part of the body of Christ. You are already walking with God. So this may be an opportunity for you to learn an evangelistic tool so that you can share with other people. So this will be a way for you to understand, like, so what's going on in the person? What should they do? So I pray that once you share the word with somebody, then you let them know, okay, now that I have shared the word with you, here are four things that you have to do. Four things that is on you at this point. And the first one is, like I said, they have to receive what the word says. They have to receive and believe that what the word says is the truth, right? And Matthew 4:4 says, Jesus answered, "It is written, man shall not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of God." And every word that comes from the mouth of God is in the Bible. 2 Timothy 3:16 says, "All scripture is God-breathed and is useful for teaching, rebuking, correcting, and training in righteousness." So we know that all scripture is God-breathed. It's from the mouth of God. And so when we share our faith and we share the word of God with somebody, it is on them. The response is to believe what the word of God says, not necessarily us, but to receive what the word of God says. The next one of the four steps would be develop and study. So that's the next step, is to develop and study. This is never ending. The develop and study process, I believe, is never ending. Even those that are already in the body of Christ, doing our faith, growing stage by stage, developing stage by stage, we have to continue to study God's word. We are to be teachable, allowing God's word to change us from the inside out. And we should be allowing God's word to do its work on the inside of us, and a change should be taking place. Things that we used to do, we don't do no more. Things that places we used to go, we don't go no more. Things we used to say, we don't say no more. People we used to hang around with, we don't hang around with no more, right? Okay. 2 Peter 3:18 says, "But grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. To him be glory both now and forevermore." Amen. Hebrews 6:1, "Therefore let us move beyond the elementary teachings about Christ and be taken forward to maturity, not laying again the foundation of repentance from acts that lead to death, and a faith in God." So that's our next step, is to develop, to grow, to begin to mature in the word of God. So, but like I said, that's never ending. You can read the Bible one time. You can read like a whole book of the Bible one month, and then a few months pass and you go back and read that same book, and I guarantee you, God will reveal something totally different to you, or he will expound on something that he gave you the very first time. It has happened to me. I've read the Bible from cover to cover more times than I can remember, but I tell you, every time I pick up the word of God, it's always something fresh and it's always something new. And I'm sure you guys can attest to that as well. Number four, live it out. Apply. That's the next step. We live it out and we apply after we study and develop, and we begin to develop it. And we got to live it out. We got to apply it to our life. The word of God applies to each and every one of us. I don't care what stage of life you're in. It applies to you. When you're giving a message to someone else first, it got to hit you first. Right? That message, before I give this to you guys, it got to hit me first, right? So, and I believe that I'm going out and I minister every Saturday. So I believe that this message is an opportunity for God to show me, like, hey, Yolanda, look, you know, you going out to minister to people, this is what their response needs to be when you introduce, when you give them what I'm giving you to give to them. This is what their response needs to be. Live it out, doing what the word of God says, even when it seems too hard. We still got to do it. Some of the stuff in the word of God, it may seem like, wow, this is so hard for me to do. This is so unreasonable. This is so complicated. But guess what? God calls us to do it. Hebrews 5 and 14 says, but solid food is for the mature, who by consistent use have trained themselves to distinguish good from evil. James 1 and 22 says, do not merely listen to the word and so deceive yourselves. Do what it says. And Luke 11 and 28 says, he replied, blessed rather are those who hear the word of God and obey it. So not only are we to be hearers, as James said, but we are to be doers. We are to be putting into practice the things that we are studying and using. I mean, think about it, guys. Like if you're in school, all of the stuff that you learned when you go to school, you don't know that the stuff actually works until you actually have to use it, right? Right now I'm in training for a new position, a new job per se. At work, and they have me in training classes. But like I told them, y'all could talk all day long. We could see all of these Zoom videos and do all of this. But until I put my hand on it, until I am able to physically get in there and start doing the work, it's not gonna stick with me. It's not gonna mean anything to me until I'm able to. I'm a visual learner. I have to touch it. I have to be able to make the mistakes and then correct the mistakes. And I learn by making errors, you know. And so think about it like that, guys. I mean, through our faith journey, through our faith walk, we are going to fall short. We're going to make mistakes. But we serve a God who is a forgiving God, right? And so he knows us. He know we're going to make a mistake. But once we make that mistake, what we have to do is learn from that mistake. And then do better the next time. And don't make, try not to make the same mistakes. Because to me, that's a vicious cycle. When we keep on making the same mistakes over and over again, never really learning. Never really learning. And so I pray that we take the word of God. We begin to study the word of God to see what God is saying for us. Then we apply that word to our lives and watch the change that it brings to us. Then the last one that I have is sharing. We're supposed to share the word of God. Don't keep it to yourself. The word, the joy, the peace, everything that you have received from accepting God, allow our Savior, from accepting God as our Savior Jesus Christ. We have to share it. Don't keep that to yourself. No. When you go find some good deal, right? I always find a good deal. When I find a good deal, what's the first thing I do? Pick up the phone, text my friends, hey, y'all, they got this special such, such, such. Or y'all better go get this from wherever y'all gonna get it from or whatever. Because it's something that I believe will be a benefit to somebody else. Well, the same applies to the word of God. The same applies. When you get a good word from God, share that thing. When you know that, life hereafter, the eternal life, is a promise to those that believe. To me, you should want everybody to reap that benefit, right? Matthew 28 and 16, which is the Great Commission. And it says, then the 11 disciples went to Galilee to the mountain where Jesus had told them to go. When they saw him, they worshiped him, but were doubted. Then Jesus came to them and said, all authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Therefore, go and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them them to obey everything I have commanded you. And surely I am with you always to the very end of the age. And I think that this scripture applies to us as well, guys. I feel like this. God, Jesus has all power in his hand. And when we go out in the authority of Jesus Christ to spread the gospel's message so that other people will receive the saving knowledge of Jesus Christ. Ephesians 4, 13 through 16 says, until we all reach unity in the faith and in knowledge of the Son of God and become mature, attaining to the whole measure of the faithfulness of Christ, then we will no longer be infants tossed back and forth by the waves and blown here and there by every wind of teaching and by the cunning and craftiness of people in their deceitful scheming. Instead, speaking the truth in love, we will grow to become in every aspect the mature body of him who is the head, that is Christ. From him, the whole body, joined and held together by every supporting ligament, grows and builds itself up in love as each part does its work. So again, when we share the word of God, we will be giving someone the foundation that they need in order to grow their faith and be stronger in their faith so that they too can go and share it with someone else. And that we won't get caught up in the wrong things when we hear of the wrong doctrines being passed around and everything. We will be more apt to truly understanding what it is that God is calling each and every one of us to do. And I know he is calling us all to share his gospel's message with everyone that we come in contact with. So then I have a few points to ponder and a few questions for you guys. 3 points to ponder. Number one, the cycle of faith is continual. It does not stop. It stays on repeat for the body of believers. We are to continue to respond from the word heard by sharing with others in the hopes that they too will respond in the way we have. That is kingdom building, right? So we started. When we started, we heard the word of God. Then we went into process of believing the word that we heard. And then the next step was to develop and to study. We got in Bible-based churches and we began to go to Bible study, Sunday school, and we began to grow in the word. And then we started applying that word that we learned to our lives, right? And then the change started taking place in us. I know all of us can go back and look back over our lives and see how we've grown and how we've changed and how we have developed because we have allowed God to begin to move in our lives. Then after that, we started taking that word and sharing it with everybody that we came in contact with. Some people in our own households was like, oh, here she come again, whatever, because when I got something good, I wanted to share it. And so we started sharing that word of God. And then that next person that we shared it with, they started doing the same thing. And then we look at, like, even with our children, we're watching them in certain stages of this same faith cycle. We're watching them developing that. They've learned the word. We put them in Bible-based churches, and now they are doing the same things. And so that's what it's supposed to be. That's the way it is supposed to be. That's that faith circle. And what it's called is kingdom building. Before you know it, you have a whole body of believer. As Ephesians 4 and 16 went on to say, for him, the whole body joined and held together by every supporting ligament grows and builds itself up in love as each part does its work. And so that's that kingdom building process. Number two, God desires all of his creation to be saved and come back into a loving relationship with him. That is what our purpose is, because God desires for all of his creation, everything that he created. He wants all of it to come into the saving knowledge of Jesus Christ so that we can rekindle that loving relationship that he first wanted when he created all of us and created all of this, the world that we live in today. Number three, for those of us that are already in a relationship with God, it is our mission purpose to ensure that others find their way back to the Father. It is our mission. It is our purpose. And I believe it starts with the ones right around you. It starts with your home. It starts with your community. We have to make sure that we are doing our part. We all have a part to play in this process, and we need to make sure that we are doing just that, and that's our part. the questions that I have for you. I know some of y'all be waiting for my questions. So the first question I have, if you are already a believer, okay, so this one is for believers, guys. If you're already a believer, think about this. Of the four responses, receive, develop, apply, and share, which one do you find the most difficult to do and why? So I'll answer that. I've received it. I believe everything that God's word says. I believe each and everything about it. I study all the time. I always read my word. I am always in my word studying, trying to get a word from God. And I've already applied God's word to my life. And I continue to do that on a day-to-day basis. I make adjustments and changes as the Holy Spirit guides me to. Whenever I do self-inventory, and I think all of us should do that, I look in the mirror, which is the Bible to me, and see what areas in my life that is not lining up. And I strive very hard to get those areas in line. You know, there are things sometimes in my mind where I think things that may be not right. So God's word will say, hey, no, it don't think of it this way. Just because the world's doing it doesn't mean that is right. So you need to change your thought process on that. And that is something that I do. The hardest one for me, guys, honestly, is sharing God's word. Yeah, I know y'all saying, what are you talking about? You share God's word every week. You get on these videos every week. Yes, I get on the videos every week, but sometimes it is hard for me to go out and like really talk to people face to face, talk to them and share the word of God with them. It's a comfort zone level, but thank God he is pulling me out of my comfort zone and I get an opportunity on Saturdays to do just that. But if I had to pick one, it is sharing. I know a lot of us struggle with that because sometimes we feel like I don't have enough Bible in me to go out and share God's word with somebody. You don't need to have enough Bible in you. You just need to have enough Holy Spirit in you, because the word says that he'll give you what to say anyway. Just start talking about God and how good he is to you. Start sharing what he done in your life, and guaranteed someone will be moved by what you are saying, and it may give them the opportunity to start to make that life change for themselves. So don't back away from that opportunity. Just start by sharing what God has done for you. The next question I have is for the non-believer. But as believers, we can still kind of answer this question. But what is standing in the way of taking the first step towards a relationship with the Father? So for the believers, this is something that you can ask a non-believer when you go out and minister and share the word of God. You can ask them, what is it that is stopping you from making that first step towards a relationship with God? What is it? You know, a lot of people, I can tell you, a lot of people, when I talk to them, it's like they talk about the physical church more than they talk about the relationship with God. And that's something that we have to let them understand. I'm not asking you about why you don't want to go to church, why you don't go in the church building, because that's when you talk to somebody about relationship with God, that's the first thing they're going to talk about. They're going to talk about religion. Oh, well, I don't fool with that because them people at the church, this and that. I'm not asking you that, though. I'm not asking you that. I'm asking you why you don't have a relationship, why you don't want to have a relationship with our Father God. Now, unfortunately, the reason why most people don't want to have a relationship with our Father God is because they associate the relationship with God with the people of God, with the people of the body of church, with the church bodies, with the religious entities. They associate God with that, but they have to realize that your relationship with God is yours, and that is apart from the church building and the people in the church. So that's the first thing that we have to let people know that are non-believers, is that don't let nothing or no one stop you from having a relationship with God. You can get that relationship with God without having to deal with religious people. And then don't always view everybody the same. You know, every church is not like that. Everybody in the church is not like that. Yeah, there's some bad apples. And unfortunately, they used to say one bad apple can ruin the whole bunch. So, and that's the reality of it. But when we talking to non-believers, guys, we want to really encourage them to have a relationship with God and to do away with religion. We're talking about relationship, right? So, an invitation to non-believers. So, if you are on this feed right now, if you're at this YouTube channel right now, and you are a non-believer, and you are wanting, you have heard this message, and you're like, wow, I want to respond to the word that I have just heard from this lady on here. I want to start by receiving this word and truly believing it. I want to start developing and studying this word, and I would like to apply this word to my life so that a change could happen from the inside of me, and then I can go out and share this word with those people that I love or that are close to me. I want to begin to share this word. I want to offer Romans 10 and 9 to you, which says, if you declare with your mouth Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. This is the first start. This is the first start, the first step. Now find you a Bible-based church, a church that truly gives the word of God as the foundation. They don't go on opinion and all of that stuff. They are not perfect people, but they are striving to share that word of God with you so that you can begin to apply it and so that you can grow and allow the Holy Spirit to guide you into the new life of Christ. So if that is you and you find this channel and you are a non-believer, I pray that you accept the word of God as truth and then begin to find that Bible-based church and begin to study that word of God and grow in the faith and then apply that word to your life to change you and then share this with others so that the cycle of faith can continue and the kingdom of God can be glorified and be lifted up. So let us close in a word of prayer. Father God, I just thank you right now, Father, for this message that you have given. Lord God, I pray right now in the name of Jesus that it is received by someone who needs to, number one, accept you as their Lord and Savior. Number two, to share your word with others, Father God. And number three, to apply your word to help us to grow in maturity in you, oh God. Father, I give you the glory and the honor and the praise because you deserve it, oh God. And I thank you, Lord God, for using me and for using this time and space, Lord God, to share what you have. Father, go with us, Lord God. Be with us, guide and lead us and direct us, Father God, and help us, Lord God, to be your hands and feet in the earth, Lord. You get the glory is my prayer in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, family, y'all go out and you have the blessed rest of your day. And remember that I love you with the love of the Lord. Bye.